Hello and welcome to today's video. My name is Joanne. If you're new here, welcome. On today's video, I'm going to be giving you a quick little tutorial on how to edit text on a Canva template. Canva templates are sold everywhere now. You can get them on Etsy. You can get templates for resumes, wedding invitations, thank you cards, birthday invitations. So with this little tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can edit the text, change any text on any template that you bought either on Etsy or any other website on the web. If you're not familiar with Canva, Canva is a graphic design website. It's completely free to use. They do have a pro account, but you really don't need a pro account if you're gonna be doing like basic stuff because they have a lot of free elements that you can use in your designs. It's a great website to make social media posts, to make flyers, posters, whatever you want to make. So today I'm gonna show you how you can edit the text and change any text on Canva templates. Before we begin, please consider subscribing. It will help me a lot, and hit the notification bell so you can get notified next time I post a video. All right, let's head over to my computer now. So once you purchase a template, they're going to send you a link. And when you click the link, you're gonna get a screen like this where it says a template created by so-and-so was shared with you, start designing now. So you're gonna click on use template. And then it's gonna bring you to this window, which means you have to sign up for Canva. Canva is free, but you do have to sign up and create an account with them in order to use their website. You can either use your Gmail or your Facebook or just your email. I'm going to use my Gmail. I'm gonna use a different account than my account only because I have a pro account, but I wanna show you how you can use it without having a pro account, so I'm using a different email. All right, so after you sign in, okay, this is skip the tour because I know how to use this. After you sign in, it's going to bring you to this window where you'll be able to design your template. This template right here is a quinceañera invitation that I made, which you can actually buy on my Etsy store if you like. I'll leave the description down below. So what we're going to do is edit these right here, which is the text on this template. I can't move this. Let me see. The girl can be moved. So if you want to make her bigger, you just click on the corners right here. You can either scale it down, bring it up, move her around, but we're just going to leave her there. That's for another video. So to edit text, you're just gonna click on the text, click and just put the cursor anywhere. So if you wanna change the last name, just backspace, let's say Mr. and Mrs. Rodriguez. Or if you wanna change the whole thing, you can just, you know, highlight the whole invitation. I mean, not the whole invitation, the whole text, delete. You see, like, once I delete everything, this looks how this looks, just to make it a little bigger, not to get confused. Just click, drag this right here, click on it and drag it to make a space so you can see what you're typing. So the Hernandez would like to invite you to a quinceañera. And then you see how it's, so to stretch this out, you just do the same thing and just grab this side right here, click on it and stretch it out. You stretch it out with your mouse. So you just, like, you know, do this. So now see how it's like on the side. We need to move that to be center. So click away from it. We're gonna click away from it. And now you click on it and you drag it to wherever you want it to be. While you're dragging it, you have to, you know, click on it and press the mouse, and then that's how you move it around. Make sure you're pressing the mouse when you're doing this. So let's leave it here in the center. So the Hernandez would like to invite you to a quinceañera. If you wanna make, if you wanna let's change quinceañera to a sweet 16. Maybe they couldn't do the quinceañera. So click on the, click inside the box, move the cursor, delete. Let's say the Hernandez wants to a sweet 16. Click away, and we don't have, but if you were to move it, you do the same thing. Click on it and just make sure the mouse, you're pressing the mouse and you move it around. You see the pink line right there? That's just telling you that it's centered. If you wanted to make the, if you wanted to change the after daughter, you can do the same thing. You can move it anywhere. If you want to make it bigger. Okay, let's leave it there. Let's change the name to Mary. So to change, it's the same process for all of them. If you just want to highlight everything, double click on it, and there it is. You can change it to Lucy. If you want, if you want to make the text bigger, just click on right here, the corners, and hold it and just stretch it out to make it either bigger, stretch it away to make it bigger, bring it in to make it smaller. So let's leave it there. And then Saturday, same thing here. You can make it bigger, smaller by clicking on the corners. You double click. If you double click, okay, let's do that again. If you double click, triple click. If it's a lot of stuff, all right. So if you double click, it's just gonna highlight one word. If you want everything, just click three times, and it will click your mouse three times, and it will highlight everything in the box. So let's change it to Sunday, comma, May 19th, 2022. And then click away to leave it the way it is. If you want to make the text bigger again, the same process, click on this little circle in the corner, hold it, hold the mouse, and either drag to make it bigger, make it smaller, we'll make it a little bigger, and center it right there. To move it around again, you just click on it and hold the mouse, and you just move it around. And the lines, you see these lines that show up is just guiding you, telling you that it's center, or it's aligned with the rest of the text. Same thing for the over here. You just you can move it down here by dragging it, hold the mouse and drag it anywhere you want. And if there are sorry for the beeping, my friend's texting me. And if you want to, like the RSVP down here, if you don't, if you want to delete a part of it, just, you know, highlight it, highlight what you want to delete. If you want everything to be in one line, just go, you have to stretch the text box. So you just click on this, the edge. Oh, stop. The edge right here. Click on it, hold it, and just pull it. And then click away. Click on it to move it around. To make it bigger again, click on the corner right here, the circle, and click hold and pull away, and it'll make the text bigger. But you see, like, once you make it bigger, let's make it a little bigger. Once you make it bigger, it's gonna be on top of her, and then it's gonna be here as well. So it's best to have it in two lines. So if you wanna put it in two line again, just find where you want the second line to start. Let's say at the phone, click on that and bring the cursor to the phone, press enter.
And there it'll be again. So now we just have to reposition it. So click away, click on it, hold the mouse, bring it to the top, right there in the center. And let's make it a little smaller. So you're gonna click on the corner, and you can click on any corner. It doesn't have to be like the left or the right. You just click on any of the corners, the circle, click, hold it, and then bring it in and make it a little smaller right there. So you're gonna click on it again on top to move it around. And there you have it. So now that this is all done, if you want to download it, all you have to do is click on either on the download button right here. And it's going to give you these options. So you can either download as a PNG, which is the highest quality, a JPEG, which is a smaller size, or a PDF print. If you're planning, some printing services require a PDF. So you can do the PDF print, which is the highest quality for the PDF version. And once you download it, let's print it as a PNG file, because you can use a PNG file to print it, to print on a website anywhere. So just click that. If you want to change the text, let's say you don't like this text right here, you just go up here to the list, and you could change it to whatever doesn't have this little crown, because that means you have to pay for it. So let's say you want to use this text, you'll just click on it, and you might have to readjust so it could be in one line. So again, just click on the sides, the edge, and pull it so it could be in one line, and click again to readjust it to the center. But maybe you want something different. You can't use these again, like I said. Let's find another free one. This is nice. It's very small. So what you can do, again, make it bigger and move it to the center. But it might be hard to read for some people. So let's just keep it simple. Let's do Laura. So now it made it a lot bigger. So again, you can click at the edges, stretch it out, and then bring it down, make it smaller, and recenter again. But see how this is on top of the leaf. So make it a little smaller. It might be too small, so maybe we can find another Montserrat. You can see, you can play around with it. This is the original one, so we'll do this, and then make it a little bigger. And let's say you like made a mistake. Let's say you accidentally deleted this by accident. Oh no, I deleted it. You just come here to the undo button, and it's right there again. And you could just keep going back. If you want to go back to like 5 steps, just click, do undo, undo, undo until you find the mistake that you want to start from. So let's change it back to the... And if you scroll all the way up, it will show you the recently used fonts that you had. So we use this one, and then make it a little bigger right there. If you want to change the Sweet 16 sign, click on it and find one that you like. Maybe you want this one. Same things, you know, make it a little smaller so it could be under this design. So every time you click on something, these are all, you see how the boxes show like this, but you, oh yeah, you can move it actually. Like these you cannot move, some you can. So let's say that you want to move this, you can move it a little. You can also make this bigger if you want, make it smaller. If you don't want it there, you can just delete it and it'll be gone. And again, if you want to bring it back, just undo the undo it and it's right there. So let's click on, let's put it back to where it was, or right there. So we'll make it a little bigger. Okay, so now that you know how to design, how to change the text and use it, you can save this by downloading your design so you can print it anywhere. So you can, to download and save your design, you need a pro account, which is, let me see if you, yeah, you have to, you apparently need a pro account, or you can just pay $1 to save it. But you can always try the pro account for 30 days free. For a 30-day free trial, and then once you download it, you can either download a PNG, JPEG, PDF, or print, and just make sure to cancel the account. Or you can just stay with it. It has a lot of great benefits. But if you're not, if you just like doing one thing, if you're just designing this one invitation, there's no point of paying $12 a month for a service you're not going to use. So just make sure to cancel as soon as you download either your JPEG, or you could just pay the $1 and you can go ahead and print them wherever you want to get a print. Yeah, you have to pay for all of them. Oh, this is new. Okay, so then once you pay for it, you download with Canva Pro, you download it, you save it to your computer, and you can print your design anywhere on the web or either a printing service near your house.
And that is how you edit text on a Canva template. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video and that you learned something from this video. If you did, please subscribe to the channel, like this video, and comment down below and tell me if you use Canva before. I post videos every week and I'll be posting more Canva tutorials. So make sure to subscribe and come back next week for my next video. Until next time, bye.